1, 2, 3, 4.
That's why they always get those explosions wrong in Hollywood.
Hi, I'm Roman Loyola with Macworld. I'm here with Gordon Ma Ung, PC World editor and Intel CPU guru, host of The Full Nerd. We were here last week to talk about the 2018 MacBook Pro, which is in front of me. There were some issues in regards to the throttling of its performance, huge hubbub about it.
Yeah.
But Apple apparently has addressed these problems with an update that came out today. The macOS 10.13.6 supplemental update was issued today through software update, and we installed it and we ran a bunch of preliminary benchmarks, and we're here to share what we found so far with this new update.
So did they fix it?
So it looks like, from what we've seen so far, that the performance has improved on the 2018 MacBook Pro. So we ran a bunch of benchmarks. Initially, we ran a Adobe Premiere CPU test. We found a 10% improvement over the unfixed 2018 MacBook Pro. Should I call it unfixed?
Unfixed, yeah.
So
the launch firmware that was in place.
Yeah, but it also results in a 20% improvement over last year's laptop.
You can hear the fans going now. And I'm not sure, did they actually say they changed, it's called the fan curve, it's when they turn the fans up. Did they say they changed that? I don't think they did.
I don't think they did, or they wouldn't comment on that at least. So we did talk to Apple about the update. So, and there's an explanation of the update in an article on the website. So, as you can see here, we're running a V-Ray benchmark. This is a 3D rendering benchmark.
Right.
We saw some improvement in this as well. There's a 7% improvement in this benchmark on the 2018 machine updated over the 2018 unfixed.
Unfixed. Original launch firmware.
Yeah, so there's a 7%.
The latest firmware. How much? 7%?
Yeah, so now the improvement of the new improved one over the old one is 18%. So that's a pretty sizable improvement. So we also ran a Blender test. Blender has a CPU benchmark, and we found a similar result. The updated MacBook Pro has a 6% improvement over the unupdated, the broken, the original.
Well,
MacBook Pro.
I think it's fair to say broken because there were real issues with that original firmware.
Yeah, and an overall 17% increase over last year's model. So we're seeing a pretty good boost than before. So it's an improvement.
But I mean, you can see this. Should we go ahead and run it again? But you should have seen in the actual close-ups, we could see that where the clock speed it was holding with Premiere and a lot of applications where it was doing horribly, it was just sort of this up and down, up and down. And after the latest firmware update, it actually holds pretty steady at the base clock, right? So you're seeing your 2.9 gigahertz, and you saw that in the Premiere one of the loads, right?
Yeah, I saw that in our Premiere test. I saw that pretty consistently on the benchmarks that we ran. So there was one benchmark that we ran that's another preliminary benchmark where we saw some throttling happening, but it was also a Premiere test that was very heavy on the CPU. It was more heavy than probably usual. We didn't use the GPU in that particular test.
Right.
So I need to go back and look at that a little more. So in that particular instance, we saw some throttling, but it was also a different instance than what we were doing.
So it was a different project we picked, specifically, I think, because it was harder. And also, we selected, rather than using the GPU to render, it's all in the CPU. And also, we selected the max render quality option.
Right.
Which anybody who's used Premiere knows when you select that, it really is just really tough on the CPU.
So yeah.
It's a pure CPU load, harsher. So it does, I got to say, that sort of indicates there could be even more tuning to come out of this.
Yeah. So interestingly enough, so there probably is more. We could probably see another update But I mean, this is this addresses the initial issue that everyone had in terms of the throttling on the MacBook Pro.
Right, and it, I mean, would you? I mean, because there's some people who are still in denial about it. It was serious. It was not made up. It was not people imagining things. And in certain cases, it was negative. Dave Lee, who originally pointed this out, he saw a worse performance. I'm sure he has the update now. He's working on it. I'm interested to see what he gets out of his project. Because he was actually seeing depressed scores at minus 15 with his video load. So.
Yeah, so keep an eye on that. So I'm sure he's working on that now. So,
But whatever the fix was, it definitely is real. It wasn't a panacea. We're definitely seeing more steady clocks. None of this bouncing all over the place.
Yes.
General performance increase across the board. I mean, some smaller where it was pretty good before. Some, you know.
Yeah.
And then some pretty decent, right? What did you see in the GPU run in Premiere? I'm sorry.
Yeah, so the GPU run in Premiere. I haven't gotten around to testing that yet. So.
But definitely. Yeah. I mean, definitely the clocks are holding to base. A lot more, most of the time, in fact, right?
Yeah. So. Yeah. So, yeah, what we've done, what I've been doing during testing is we run the Intel Power Gadget, and it shows performance, temperature, a couple other things. And, as you mentioned before, we were seeing erratic.
Right.
Now it's just like almost a flat line, like if you would see on an EKG when someone's dead. So yeah. Not that this is dead, but.
And then one thing I want to point out, this is Power Gadget, Intel Power Gadget. There, at one point on Saturday, this is how fast this entire story is moving.
Right.
It vanished from Intel's website, and then everybody said this is a cover up. And then a few hours later, it actually came back and an updated version came out, I believe, right?
Yeah, an updated version came out, and we've been using that updated version. So. I'm sure there are people thinking of conspiracies about that one.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. The other thing is I'd like to go all. So this is a 2017 7th Gen Kaby Lake H quad core. This is the brand new Coffee Lake H 6-core CPU. A lot of people are going, why not do i7 this versus the next one?
Yeah.
I mean, the i7 current generation versus the i9 current generation. And I got to say, I think that's a valid concern, but the issue really is that the new 2018 MacBook Pro was actually going backwards in performance for some people for some loads, and that's really not good. So I think what we want to settle now is that it is not slower than this previous generation MacBook, it looks like.
Yeah. So we have some more testing to do, but so far it's looking good, or it's looking better than before.
Yeah.
So, and we'll have a... more complete report coming up.
Yeah. The other thing is this, it's not confined just to the 15-inch, right? This is everything.
Right. So the update is for all 2018 MacBooks. So the 13-inch MacBook Pro without the touch bar did not really get updated. So it's really the MacBook Pros that were updated this past couple weeks.
Yeah.
So it's the two 13-inch models, two 13-inch models and the two 15-inch models.
Right, because the base one did not get a Kaby Lake R version. It's still base, so the basic one.
Right, yeah.
But basically, a lot of people were wondering whether this affects the Core i7 8th gens, and it does as well, according to Apple, because this is across all of them.
Yeah. So you can get the update through the App Store. Look under the updates. It takes about 20 minutes to run. Your Mac will have to restart. It's going to be a different kind of installation than maybe you're used to because it is updating firmware. So you'll actually see a different screen that comes up that you may not have recognized before if you've been updating your Mac and doing software updates. It's a little bit different, but don't be alarmed. It tells you what's going on. The screen actually goes black for a little bit.
Okay. Yeah.
Because it's updating firmware.
Yeah.
So.
So the other thing is because I know people just have a lot of questions. I still have a lot of questions. The big one to me is like, how in the world did this even happen? There are some theories. I don't think we should get into that now, but we are going to do a podcast tomorrow. I think Macworld's podcast live.
Yes.
Tomorrow. So tune into the Macworld podcast live on YouTube.
On YouTube and on Twitter on the Macworld Twitter feed. Macworld YouTube channel. It will go live tomorrow at 10 a.m. Pacific time. So adjust your clocks accordingly for whatever region you live in. And it will be me and Gordon and Jason Cross from Macworld. We're pretty much dedicating that whole podcast to the 2018 MacBook Pro. If you have any comments or questions about that, let us know.
And actually come in and drop a live question in during the podcast.
Yeah. Yeah, we definitely want to hear from you. So we've got, I've got more testing to do. And so we'll get back to you tomorrow on the podcast. So yeah. That does it for right now. So I'm Roman Loyola.
Gordon Ng. Check you out tomorrow.
Check you out tomorrow.